Hello everybody, in this Rhino video demo, I would like to demonstrate the modeling of a pillow. By the way, this demo is based on the request of a viewer of this channel. Okay, let's start. Okay, I reckon the first command that I should use should be this command, okay? The Subnet Plane command on the Subnet toolbar, okay? And I'm going to set the X count to 4 and the Y count to 3, okay? Okay, something like that, okay? And let's turn on the control points and pull up the basic shape. Okay, so I got like something like that. Okay, I reckon that maybe I can subdivide the form further as I want to create a detail over here. So I'm going to click on the subdivide, subdivide icon, do one subdivision, okay, to create something like that. Okay, and then I will want to select these four faces, and the easiest way to do it is to turn on the selection filter sub-object, select these four faces by pressing and holding a shift key, and okay, I want to extrude a detail from here, but before that, let's pressing and holding the shift key, I'll do a proportion scaling to scale this down somewhere like that, and I'm going to bring this down a little bit, okay, and then extrude out a detail. Sorry, let's bring it down one more section like that, okay, before I do extrude up, okay, so I'm going to extrude this up, okay. Be to be somewhere around here, and let's do one more extrusion, okay, something like that. Okay, now let's shape this further. Okay, I think what I'm gonna do is to make this part a bit more rounded, okay. Double clicking on this edge, selecting the edge loops, okay. Okay, something like that. And then let's hold the shift key to do a proportional scaling inwards, okay, so we can get like this kind of shape over here. Okay. I reckon that maybe the top part can be slightly bigger, okay. Okay, and this one can be smaller, and let's bring this downwards, okay. I think this can be smaller. Okay, I'm going to create another ring over here, and we can do so by using the insert edge and set this to ring, the type to ring. Okay, so I'm going to create one more ring here, and let's double click. And then scale this a bit bigger, so get like this kind of shape. Okay, basically I want this kind of shape. Okay. Okay, something like that. Okay, you can make this smaller or bigger, depending on your requirement. Okay. let's make this slightly smaller. Okay, I think it's kind of big though. Okay, so I'm going to press and hold shift key, make this even smaller, something like that. Okay. Maybe let's turn on the points. Do a little bit of adjustments. Okay, I think maybe I'll need another ring here. Okay, and let's do the sub ring again. Okay, set this to ring. I think it's kind of hard though. Maybe a better way of doing it is to turn on the control points and work with this control points. Okay, so what I'm going to do is go to the selection toolbar and do a select U or a select V depending on the situation. Okay, so I think I want to oops, I don't seem to be able to get what I want. Okay, so okay, let's just manually select the control points that needs to be repositioned. Okay, something like that. I'm gonna move this up. Scale this. Got something like that. Okay. Okay, now let's mirror this onto the bottom half here. Okay. So select this, sorry, need to deactivate the subject, okay. Let's do a mirror. Okay, got something like that, okay. And I'm going to join these two halves together to form it into a single sub-D object by using the join command. Select this and this, okay. You can see that the edge has been nicely rounded. Okay, if you're satisfied with the form, we can stop here. However, I think what I'm going to do next is to add further creases on the pillow for added realism. Okay, and to do that, I reckon that we could use Blender sculpting tools to assist us. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to select this object. Go to file, export selected, and export it as a pillow, okay, and save it. Okay, it's a OBJ file, by the way. Okay, so set it to polygon mesh objects. Click okay. Now let's head over to Blender. I'm going to delete this default cube and go to file, import, and import our OBJ. Okay, it's in. Let's head over to the sculpting and do a bit of sculpting. It's kind of dark over here though. Okay, I reckon that I want to create some kind of creases. Okay, so don't click on the crease, and you might want to adjust the strength and radius based on your requirement. Just use the default, okay? So you can create like creases for added realism. You might want to increase the strength. Okay, I'm not really very good with sculpting, so you may be able to do a better job than me, okay? Okay, I think I want to add some more crease over here. Something like that. Okay, for added realism. Now let's do a bit of smoothing. Okay, I reckon that I need to like smooth this a little. Getting from bad to worse. Not gonna smooth it. Okay. Assuming that I'm done with the necessary sculpting work, okay, we can bring the stuff back to Rhino, okay. Okay, maybe something like that will do, okay. So once you are done with this, let's export this pillow back to Rhino, okay. So let's go to file, export, and let's export as the wavefront object again, and I'm going to call this pillow 2, okay. Export obj, and let's head over to Rhino again. Let's hide this for time being, okay. And then bring our new object in, okay, pillow 2. Okay, I think I need to rotate this. Okay, you see pillow 2 comes in quite nicely, and we can see that there are like further details, okay, for added realism. And unfortunately, it's in a mesh format, and if you want to convert it to Subd, we can do so by either using the quad remesh, okay, or use the to Subd command. But I think I will use the quad remesh, okay. So I can click on this, click the quad remesh, and have the convert to Subd turn on, and then detect hard edges and so on and so forth. And you might want to play with all these values to see what gives the best result, okay. So I think I'll just use these default inputs, okay, and click OK. Okay, so now we have our Subd form below, okay. And if you need to further convert it to NURBS, you can of course at the command prompt type to NURBS to convert this again, okay. With that, I think I've come to the end of this demo. That's been useful to you. See you, bye.